Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Iowa Plains. And today, we have quite a lot to do. So as you can see, we've got the contract combine. And it's over here on field 22. And I've also accepted another contract for field 13 that is also canola. And it's also going to the grain selling station. So field 13 is right here. Field 14 is already harvested, and then we're down over here next to field 22. So we have this field here and still field 13 to harvest. And then I bought field 5 here, and we're going to harvest that with our combine because we need wheat and oats still, because we're going to be heavy in the flour production. So let's get into it. We're going to set that guy off. We're going to set this guy off. And we do want the straw swath. And as you can see, I brought the plow over to our wheat field. And we just need to pick up all these bales. Whoa. Easy there, truck. Alright, so there was 23 bales there. Which is not bad. For right now, these bales are going to go right here along the pig shed. And they kind of need to be a little bit closer than that. That'll work. All right, we can go ahead and set this guy off. He should be fine. I did also buy a fertilizer and lime spreader here, and it's filled up with lime to do the wheat field that is currently being plowed. Let's see, we need this guy. We're going to go take it over to the new oat field. I will also be selling that oat field back to the AI because I don't really want it and we need the money to buy other things like a seeder because we still need a seeder or a planter, either one or both of them for that matter. All right, before you get any fuller, I want to stop you and unload. Because I have a feeling once we fill this truck up, it's not going to want to go anywhere. All right, is this able to move? Well, I know it's going to be able to move, but is it going to be able to go past 18 miles an hour? And it is. That's good to know. All right, so it's got quite the speed still. It is only 10% loaded, though. So for right now, we'll keep it. We might end up selling that truck here later on if it's stuck in that one gear. And somebody has a full grain tank. Or almost full grain tank. It looks like somebody has completed their task. I would assume that's... Oh, that's the plow, actually. I honestly forgot about the plow. So we'll go have a look at that here in a second. I think our contract harvester needs to be unloaded, but it looks like he's down on the other end of the field, so he should be able to make it back. And then our combine is going to need to be unloaded on its way back. So when we get to the end here, we'll stop and go look at the plow. Oh, he's not done at all. I guess he's almost done. He only had two more passes to do. So we're going to hire that guy back off. And we are going to get into this guy. And we're going to do a little bit of mowing. Alright, the contract combine needs to be unloaded, so we're going to take this down to the actual grass field here, and we're going to hire off the worker. Alright, that will do good for that. We actually need to stop this guy. How is our plow doing? He's actually almost done here. Or is he done? He is done. All right. All right, we'll come back to that in a second. We need to get this guy back going so we can get this contract done. All right. This guy's almost full, so we'll get our truck. While we wait for the combine to turn around, we're going to finish up the plowing here. All right, has he turned around yet? Yep, it looks like he has. All right, now that the combine's empty, can I still go above 18? No, I cannot. What happens if I go backwards and then go forwards? Nope, it's still stuck in eighth gear. So that means this truck is going away. It's a nice truck. It's a nice mod. But there's just problems with it that they didn't account for, apparently. So while this drives really slowly, we're going to take a look here. And we're going to buy this guy. And we're going to make this case IH red. Inside's going to be black. The vinyl color isn't showing, but it's still going to be case red. That actually, the rim color needs to be black. And there we go. And we've almost went off the edge there. That could have been bad. We made it a lot further than I thought we would. Why am I not going anywhere? What is going on here? I can go backwards. I just can't go forwards. Now I can go forwards. That's weird. This truck is weird. A car behind me? No. I'm just hearing things. I really thought there was a car behind me honking at me. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and sell those things. We now need a trailer. And we are going to buy the Wilson Trailer 53-foot Super Hopper. We want all the mudguards. We don't want attachers. We don't really want to mess with the capacity. Or maybe we do. Yeah, let's do a little upgraded capacity there. And everything else is fine. Alright, so this is a brand new truck. I like it. Nice car stopped on the middle of the road. We always like that. And I suppose we now need a grain cart. But I really don't want to buy one. Because I forgot to see when I got off here last time to look at grain cart mods. So for now, we'll live with it. We need our plow here. We're going to finish plowing up. All right, well, that folds up. That combine is full. So we're going to go unload it. Anything in the sale? No, there's not. How is our combine doing along? He's only 38% full, which is perfect. This guy is almost empty. And it looks like we're going to have to go unload this, JCB. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Alright, we'll leave this guy right there. This guy seems to be done. He's not even close to being done yet. But we'll just clean up these messes that he made. And we might as well go all the way around the field now. Probably should have done that first. But it's okay. Yep, we definitely need a grain cart. Like, really badly. But that will do it for today, guys. I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.